wrestling family, but I think in the past year has taken himself to the pinnacle of professional wrestling. He's very versatile besides driving trucks, sewage trucks.
Oh my God.
He's also my very good friend, Eddie Guerrero. Eddie, welcome to the show.
That's true, ladies and gentlemen.
Eddie, you came and trained with us when you were ready to make your comeback. And I'm not going to get into detail. I'm going to let you say what you want. But over the last couple of years, you've overcome some major hurdles and obstacles in your life to come, to achieve where you're at right now. I mean, you are no doubt one of the most popular wrestlers on the SmackDown at this point in time.
All I can really guess is obviously thank God and thank God for people like you that he's put in my life, you opened basically your family, wrestling family to me, and coming fresh out of rehab and struggling, man. I went straight to your facilities, man, and you were great with me. You heard me cry, you heard me, you just were near to me and the facilities and all the boys there, always be thankful to God that he put a person like you, like Les Thatcher, in my life on my way, man. It's a day-to-day struggle. By the grace of God, I take it day by day and worry about today.
But you found out two things during that time. You loved your family and the professional wrestling business more than the other things, right?
Oh, yeah. You get to a point where you're losing it all, and you gotta look at yourself, and you really gotta ask yourself this question: what's really in my life? What's really the true things in my life? What do I really want out of this? And for me, it's obviously my faith in God and my family. Wrestling is a part of my family; it always has been. From the time I can remember. With my father and my brothers, now by the grace of God, now he feeds me and he feeds my kids.
That's great. One of the things, of course, we've got a lot of young fellas watching this probably that have aspirations to make it in wrestling. And we were talking before we started taping about the way your father, before you ever got in the wrestling ring, there were like about seven different roles that you had to perfect, and if we could show, which we can't show them on camera, they're very difficult even for the most athletic person, but that was the type of structured training and discipline that you had to go through before Dad would even think about getting you in a ring and teaching you a hold or a bump.
Right. Well, that's true. My dad called them the basics, He says, learn your basics the best, to the best of your ability, because he always told me that. Learn your basics and you'll be a good wrestler. The better you learn the basics, the better you wrestle you will be. I believe that to this day, In everything in life, always go back to basics.
Right.
It's about a good base or a good solid foundation. If you have a good solid foundation, when the storm comes, or weather, if you don't have a solid foundation underneath you,
I guess the first notice of Eddie Guerrero in the States was that War of the Worlds,
Hard Bar.
Yes, exactly. But, and then as you came along to ECW and WCW, they more or less classified you as a cruiserweight, which you're not the biggest guy in captivity by far. But now, there's an old saying when I was a kid, if you know what you're doing, no one remembers how big you are. And you've been out there against some huge opponents, and with your heart and with your talent, no one says, gee, Eddie's smaller than those guys. You've hit the pinnacle. You, to me, right now, are probably one of the hottest attractions in this company.
I go back to what you said. You wrestle with your heart, and that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to wrestle with my heart. And, that's what these fans deserve. Not tell all the boys back there, if you don't come to wrestle, if you don't come to wrestle with your heart, get out. Because there's a million people that love to be doing what you're doing. And I, myself, am guilty of that, coming to wrestle the way, in the state that I was before, if you want to call it high, coming to wrestle in that state, that the fans don't deserve that. They deserve the best from each and every one of the wrestlers that guys are, whether it's a shit, as long as the wrestler gives the best that he's got to give, that's what it's all about, and that's what the people deserve.
Well, the one thing I think with you, that's, I mean, I've told people that when you were with us at camp, when you were talking to the younger guys, you could feel your passion coming out through your conversation. I mean, you would start to get emotional with how you felt about this business, and I think you would agree with me that anyone that has made any kind of indentation or impression in this business has that same passion, and that will overcome sometimes a lack of talent or a lack of athleticism, whatever, because how many guys do we know that maybe aren't great athletes but have such a passion for this industry that they've made it?
Right. You know, you take the words right out of my mouth. What can I say after you say, oh? Give me a break, Les. Let me say
something. Okay, speak up.
No, but the truth is, yeah, that is the truth. You know, passion goes a long way in this business, you know. It goes away a long way in any business, in life in general, you know. Man, this is wrestling, you know, sports entertainment. It's the greatest entertainment there is in the world, you know. And you go out there, that's where it's circled. Just get it. Not only just release it, you know. I don't know. For me, it's kind of like it's the biggest high I got, man. It's therapy. It's my high in life, if you want to call it that. Now, you know, it's just you go out there and you give it all. Whether you're angry, you know, you can be angry, happy, sad, you know, funny mood. I don't care. You know, just go out there and just release it. And you know, right now, by the grace of God, I got that blessing right now. Take advantage of it while it's here, because you know it's not here all the time, you know, and it won't be here for the rest of my life.
That's one of the sad things about our profession. We're limited in terms of years that we can spend in it, and then you get frustrated like an old man like myself and have to sit around and talk to the young guys.
You know what I'm envious of? What are they doing?
I tell you what I'm envious of is all the cool rides.
Oh yeah, Orderly, man, the lowriders home.
Yes.
Yeah. Hey, what's up? Why didn't you have one back in the
to HWA, huh?
It wasn't in the budget.
I told you to get it.
But that's what every time I see, because I'm an old hot rodder anyway, and I see it. Yeah, damn, man, he gets all these great rides.
That's one thing. I'm real lucky, man. I get all the sweet rides.
You gotta customize that sanitation truck.
Hey man, everything's possible, yes.
Of course, Chavo's back now. You guys are doing some teamwork, yeah. Right? But I'm so happy for you because I know how much you love this business and everything. All your personal problems are aside, and as you say, it's day to day. But every time I see you step in the ring, I realize that you're getting that high, and that passion is there, and you're making the people in the nosebleed seats feel it just the way you feel it. I think that's a commodity that everyone doesn't have.
You know, that's. Sit back and all I can do is be thankful to God, to the people like you in my life. Obviously thankful to the fan, you know, whether you hate me, whether you cheer me, I don't care. Well, you know, as long as you don't sit on your hands.
And that's the amazing thing to me. You're trying to, you know, you want to steal and cheat.
Yeah,
and nobody wants to be mad at you.
Great message, isn't it? Yeah. Lie, steal, cheat. To win. You know, it's just, I think what, you know, obviously it started off to be the bad guy thing, and it's still a bad guy thing. I think, if you want to say it, me and Chavo are the people that people love to hate. So there comes a point in time where you say, I like hating that guy, you know. And sooner or later, the I likes become more of the hate, more than the hates,
yes.
You know. And I think me and Chavo and myself, I should say, are at that point right now where people are just enjoying the entertainment, the work aspect of it. And because we go out there and we wrestle passionately.
Right.
And the people see that and they feel that. And you know, now it's more of a respect with the people. But I'm sure that if we decide to piss them off, we'll piss them off.
I'm sure you will. My friend, I'm so happy for you. You're one of the greats in this area. There's no two ways about it. The door is always open here in Cincinnati for you anytime you want to come home.
Once again, I thank you for your heart. I thank you for your knowledge. I thank you for your friendship. May God bless you, your family, and HW.
God bless you, my friend. It's so good to have you. It's good to see you healthy.
Thank you.